Good morning, students. We'll see the demo program of program number 5, Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm. Now we'll start from main. To understand the concept, I request you to refer the previous slide so you can understand the concept of Cohen-Sutherland and how this algorithm is working. All those concepts are explained. Now I'll directly explain the program demo. We'll start from main. So for this program, we'll take the input. You can see the output window here. The line coordinate should be given as an input. So I'll give x0, y0 and x1, y1 as well as this window coordinate. This is called world coordinate, world window coordinate. So xw, yw, here xw, yw. So these coordinates will be given as an input. Now, for explanation purpose, I have taken the standard value. So by activating this line, you can give your x0, y0, x1, y1. Let me start from main. So first we are initializing the glut along with C++. Then we are initializing the display mode. So this is one 2D program. So single buffering is sufficient. So glut single RGB color model we are using. Glut init window size. The initial window size will be 500, 500. And the initial window position, initially it was coming here, so that 00. This is the output window with this title. So you can see the title here, Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm. We are calling the display function. So once the line is drawn, the output will be coming here. We have some myInit. We'll see the init functions. And this main loop is keeping all your callback functions under a loop. So till you close the program, the main will be under a loop. Now we'll see the myInit. So can you understand this myInit? Clear color. This is the background color. It's a white color. So we can see the white color background here. And color. Color of the output what we are going to draw. So that is here RGB. So red color. The point size is 1 and in it we should initialize this GL projection 4x4 matrix. So the output is projected and converted to a matrix format that is stored in this GL projection matrix. By calling GL load identity, we are multiplying the GL projection matrix with identical matrix. So you know the identity matrix. So diagonals will be 1. So after this line, the output can be drawn a normalized format. So that's why we are multiplying with load identity. GLU ortho 2D is a 2D command. So left, right, bottom, top. So we are setting almost 500, 500 only on positive side. If user is giving the value negative side, so you can set minus 500 here and minus 500 here. So that's all in myInit. We'll go to the algorithm now. So we'll go to the display function, display. For this program, I have taken this input, x0 equal to 20, y0 equal to 20, and x1, y1 is 50, 100. So that is this line. Okay. So this output we'll see later. Let me explain only this input now. We are clearing the color buffer. This is some color variable we are setting. We are drawing the input line, GL begin, GL end, GL line. So x0, y0 to x1, y1. So this line is drawn first. And the next coding, color we are setting, RGB, blue color we are setting. So this is blue color. We are drawing a clipping window. That is x min, y min to x max, y max. That four value we are passing, these four value. So that is drawn as a line loop. Now input is drawn here, that is the input line and clipping window is drawn. We are calling the actual algorithm, Cohen-Sutherland line clip and draw. We are passing this four parameter, 20, 60, 150, 100. Now we'll go to the algorithm. So here is the algorithm, Cohen-Sutherland line clip and draw. Here 20, 60, 50, 100 is passed to these values. So we are initializing these three variables. Already I have explained in the concept slide. we are initializing one more variable, boolean variable, accept equal to false, done equal to false. First let us calculate the outcode. So in this input we have two outcode, this is left side and this is right side. So this is marked as outcode 0 and this is outcode 1. So outcode 0 we are calling compute outcode and passing the value. So 2060 should get an output, actually this left side you can see. Now we'll see the function, how it calculates. So we'll go to the compute outcode function. So here is compute outcode function, the values are passed here. So it comes to this function, initially a variable code equal to 0. Now you can see this is left side, right? So all these if cases will become false, leaving only this. So code equal to code, this 0 or left. So you know the 9 regions for left side, which value will be assigned, that value will be passed. So here we have assigned 0, 0, 0, 1. So that is the value we have passed. You see the output now. So left will assign this 0, 0, 0, 1. And same manner you pass your outcode 1 value here, that is 150, 100. So it is falling on your right side. So it returns 0, 0, okay, this is not the correct value, I have to update. For tracing, I have written a wrong value here. So the actual right value will be assigned here. So outcode 0 and outcode 1 will take a variable. Now it performs do operation. Now for this case, is it completely accept case? No. Is it completely reject case? No. So this is for completely inside line. Our line is not inside. So this will become false. It is not completely outside also. So this is also false. Now this function will be executed. So in this case, what we have to do? This intersection point we have to calculate first. So outcode out equal to outcode 0. This is conditional operator, outcode 0 colon outcode 1. Now in this case, which outcode is outside? 0 or 1? Both are outside. First we are passing outcode 0. So in that case, condition becomes true. So first time outcode out takes outcode 0 as a result. Now this outcode 0 is left side or right side or bottom side or top side. So that is calculated on these four cases for this given input, which is correct, left is correct. So the last value is correct. So after calculating this left, the new xy, so we are calculating the new xy here. For left case, I will get this new xy. So that new xy will be assigned to x0, y0. And same manner, when you pass the other endpoint, outcode 1 will be calculated. So this case is calculating your intersection point. After this, again the for loop will go up. So now, this line will be passed. This intersection point is what? 0, 0, 0, 0. And this intersection point, it's also falling inside 0, 0, 0, 0. So this is completely accept case. So the first if condition, all 0, not of 0 is becoming 1. So if of 1, true. So that time it accept the line and done equal to true, it comes outside. So it comes to this line, if accept equal to true. This is our actual input. We have to draw the output in the scaled up window. It's a bigger window. So we are calculating the scaling factor Sx and Sy, and that Sx and Sy is multiplied with your current output window, that is your viewport. You call this is window port and this is viewport. So that is multiplied and the new line, the clipped line is drawn and clipped window is drawn as well as the clipped line is drawn. So now let me see the output with different line coordinate. So here this is two side intersection. Now let me change this value. I'll give only one side intersection. Now you can see the output. It is on only one side. So only one clip point will be calculated and this is trivially accept case. We'll draw the output. Now we'll see the trivially reject case. The last one is trivially reject case. So here no output is drawn. The input line is like this. The input window, clipping window is like this. So nothing to be clipped. So no output is coming. Now one more case. We'll see trivially accept case. This is trivially accept case. The example line is falling fully inside the clipping rectangle, so the output is drawn. I hope you understand the Cohen-Sutherland line clipping. Thank you.